How's it going, Global Ninja Turtles? We are here with a much-needed video. I personally think this is a much-needed video. The way we sort of rank units and stuff like that is pretty toxic. I'm just going to be honest with you. Like, it's not really that good. We don't give, like, fair treatments and stuff like that. And that doesn't go for just Global and for JP as well, too. We don't give fair assessments for a lot of units and stuff like that. We just basically, who's better than this person? Who's better than that person? And that's basically the ranking that people's been going with for so long. It's like, oh, it's not better than this person, then blah, 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 blah. Really not fair to the units that come out and stuff like that and what they're supposed to be doing. So I propose a new ranking system. It's sort of a ranking system that we really had a long time ago, but sort of polished a little bit more better now because of basically mechanics and stuff like that. So I'm proposing that we go back to a old style of ranking, which I will show in a second. But if you're new to the channel, you like what you see, subscribe. Turn on notifications where you get notified when we go live and put up more videos. What are you doing, man? You need to subscribe to the channel. I was going to say we need 32,000, but we literally just recently hit that last night on live stream. So that was absolutely incredible for each and every last one of you guys that was there for that. Appreciate you so much for that. Absolutely incredible. Thank you so much. Like, seriously, thank you so much. No more glazing, okay? No more glazing. I'll get into the video. Okay, so I'm proposing a new ranking system that we can have in Global Dokkan Battle that I personally feel like is, well, not even just Global, in all of Dokkan Battle. I personally feel like this is going to be more of a better ranking system, to be fair. And like I said, I just put these units as placeholders for me personally right now of how I see it, how I like them. But for things that's currently not here, stuff like that you could probably think of, like best dodge unit, stuff like that. Like, I kind of sort of put that with like defense, but with dodge, if you want to be like the best dodge unit, you can debate that. You can do this. You can make even more like renditions of this whatsoever. But I just put this as like the five really focal points of cards and stuff like that. And then like the subs of like how thing is with just damaging of like dodge and counters and stuff like that. Like, then you could have that, or like person that has like the best like active skill or something like that. You could probably do that and put that in, just like you could do your own animations, OSTs, and blah blah blah. But for the things that really necessarily matter in Dokkan Battle, this is what I put it as. So basically, as you can see right in the middle up here, I put best all around. So I'm just gonna be like this, and I'm gonna say this for this one because, like I said, this is my take, but you guys can have your own sort of take on this one if you want. I'm probably going to maybe tweet this out, and you could probably take off the ones that you don't want on there or something like that, or just copy over them and make your own list, because I feel like I should probably make a video or at least a live stream. If I have a lot of submissions, I'll probably make a live stream of it at some point. I feel like I need to know how the rest of the audience out there necessarily ranks units themselves and how you would go with the units and stuff like that. So I'll explain why I put certain people there and stuff like that. Best all around, I put that as the best all around, because let's be honest, I put it as Beast Gohan. This Beast Gohan is your best all around character in the game. Like, I would put that as like, yeah, it's number one, best all around, but obviously there's other units that are best at other, you know, aspects of not just being all rounded, like things that make them stand out the most for certain things. Beast Gohan, in my opinion, like, it's you stand out in everything. Sort of situation. Like, you do a lot of damage, you can defend like crazy. Like, the other thing is he doesn't have to transform, so that's one of the reasons why I'm saying best all around. Like, units that don't even have to transform or anything to just be better. So in a situation like later on down the line, if we have like a new unit that's better than Beast Gohan but he has a transformation, then it would just top over Ultra Instinct Goku because, well, it's a transformation unit. It's not best all around without transformation. So I'm leaving that as like units that don't have to transform. They're just already the best. Basically, like, you get one every year and it's clearly better than everything else all around it until maybe like something else comes along or something like that. Because again, we don't necessarily know how they're going to really go with how they're coming out with units and how busted they're going to be. Because, like, I put this as like even easy A, stuff like that, like whatever it is. It's like, if they're the best at that certain thing, they're the best. So like I said, with defense, I put Vegeta there because I think the man can get 80% damage reduction. Starts out with 50% damage reduction right off the bat. Like, and he can defend and dodge and blah, blah, blah. Like, he's literally incredible, especially after using him on Global Dokkan Battle a lot. Like, on the Beast Gohan team, it's like, I never have to worry about him whatsoever at all. And like I said, I could easily put Ultra Instinct Goku, like the AGL one here as well too. But if you want to do that and actually like rely on dodge and stuff like that, that's why I didn't really put it there, because he doesn't really have to rely on dodge. It's like he's basically get hit and be like more tankier. So it's like, That's why I have him there at number one, as in my opinion. Like I said, you guys can have your own opinion. You can go and do your own rendition of this or how you want. If you agree with this base start out so far, I appreciate it. And thank you. Glaze a little bit. Thank you. But I like, do your own thing. Let me know. Let me see it and stuff like that. So best attacker, I put it at Jiren. Like, you've heard me say this multiple times that I think Jiren is literally the best attacker in the game. This is your damage dealer. This is basically what I'm saying. Like, the person does, like, the most damage, like, in a turn. Like, Jiren is doing horrendous damage for the opponent. Like, it's horrendous numbers that he's putting up. You've seen the showcases. Like, you know his stats. He's putting up crazy numbers. Like, if we get, like, more, like, even though you could put, like, Ultra Instinct Goku in there, stuff like, I don't think that even with Ultra Instinct Goku doing his counters right now, I don't think he's better in terms of attacking and stuff like that, just because Jiren's just outright damage, just damage central. And, like, you can even throw Cell Max for AoEs. Like, that's another category that you can throw in is AoE. Like, what's the best AoE? Like, you can be like, oh, well, probably going to be Cell Max. So, you know, that's why I didn't put that there, because with AoE, it's more like if you're going against, like, a really hard event and there's, like, multiple, like, fighters in that you're, like, going up against multiple enemies, then obviously he's going to out damage because he's AoEing like crazy. So, like, he's going to out damage, especially with additionals and stuff like that. That's why I didn't put him there, and AoE would be its own thing that you could really throw in. But in terms of just damage on single target damage, it's Jiren. Like, let's be honest, it's Jiren. Then I got transforming units. So basically what I was talking about before about, like, oh yeah, a unit can be better, but if it's just the best transforming, because that's the basis of the Beast Gohan argument right now that most people really have. Because let's be honest, global, you kind of got the Dokkan, like, you got global shock right now. It's a little disease where you basically have to wait and see a unit that is dominating on the one side of the game for a very long time, and then you literally get them, and then you get shocked into seeing another unit that pops up, and you really can't take it. You just can't take it no more. So global shock has hit you. JP players, they don't really have that problem. They never heard of this this disease or anything like that. But for this global shock, it hit hard. Like I said, transform Master Ultra Instinct Gohan. Excuse me, Goku is better than Gohan. Like, he is. For the ones that currently have him, that summoned on him early this morning, that got him, that already got him awakened, that have been using him, could probably tell you that too. Like, maybe the one time or two times that I seen him in a fight that I needed it and he got to transform to it. My guy, he's cooking. Let him cook right now. Like, even JP players that use him for a second, have been in hard offense and stuff like that, they'll tell you. Let him cook right now. Listen, global. The global shock is kicking in for you. He is. So that's why I have him as best transforming units, to sort of put that around. That way you can be like, all right, well, Beast Gohan still, again, outright better than everyone, just right out the gate. As soon as the fight starts, he's the best. Then I put the next best thing that people really need to, like, pay attention to and stuff like that, which was best supporter. Who's the best supporter? I put, like, actually, now that I'm looking at this, it's funny that I'm looking that every last one of these are a different type. And I swear I didn't do that on purpose or anything like that. I just literally went with the units that I actually thought were the best to represent what I'm talking about here. And damn, that's kind of funny. But for best support, I put Boo. Because with Boo, I mean, he literally starts out all types, attack and defense. Like, you're getting three key and attack and defense, all type. In any all type, and I'm also factoring in how good the unit is outside of the support as well, too. Because, obviously, if a unit is very good supportive, but also can't tank anything themselves, can't do any damage in hard events, they don't really do anything, they're just going to get you clapped every time, you're not really going to run them. But Kid Boo, you're going to run him, because he's absolutely incredible. And like I said, his stock only goes up when we get even more physical support, and also when we get an all types leader 200%, and you can throw him on there, and then everyone's just getting love. Like, regardless if you're 70% above HP or below, you're still getting an incredible boost from him, and also seeing a unit that can literally tank, like, with damage reduction and everything. Like, it's kind of hard to not beat Kid Buu as best supporter currently right now in game, because the dude, like, if I wanted to say he could be, like, one of the best all-around units, he could literally be one of the best all-around units. High damage, can defend, supports like crazy. Like, you could put him in there and be like, oh yeah, he's, like, one of the best all around it. But since he's really looked at as more on his passive of support, with also the afterthought of being like, oh damn, this unit does a crazy amount of damage. And the fact that he's healing as well too. It's like, I could have had a whole list of best healers and stuff like that. You see what I'm saying? Like, going through here, like, there's so many different categories that we actually have to be able to fairly rank units, that I personally feel like the way that we're going right now and how it is, you can let me just say this. You can agree or disagree if you want. Like, I'm just saying, the way we're going currently right now with ranking units, it's not going to be good, especially when you got a worldwide celebration that's going to be coming up. It's going to introduce a whole nother level of units as well, too, that's going to be very good. This could easily change, and Beast Gohan could be the second best all-around unit in the game. Like, or Ultra Instinct Goku could be the second best or third best transform unit, as far as we know, because we don't know what we're getting. Like, Vegeta could be the second or third best defensive unit. We have no idea. Like, Jiren could get out damaged by somebody else going forward after the worldwide celebration. We have no idea. But for right now, I'm just seeing this, I feel like this is the best thing, because we literally, I named off like six or so other categories, like sub little categories that you could have glaze all up through here and be like, yeah, this is this, that's that, that works too. I like you could literally do this for like at least six or seven other sort of categories in Dokkan Battle, where you can have the best AoEs, the best dodge units, you know, like just the best counters in the game, like all that stuff. Like, you could have all of those if you really want. I just want the five of the most important sort of things right now that most people look at when they're in the game. Really four technically, and then the fifth is just the best all-around character, and that's just it. You can let me know if I'm cooking or not, like, in the comment section below. Like I said, if you think I'm not, it doesn't hurt my feelings whatsoever at all. I promise you it don't. But for the way it is, I think we're going to need to pick up on this more than what we're doing currently right now, because like I said, it's not fair to other units to just like be like, oh, I'm comparing you to just Beast Gohan because Beast Gohan is the best all-around character. Like, then I'm just going to be completely like blind and negligent to everything else that the other characters said does better than the all-around best unit. Like, there's a unit that can be the best everywhere. Like, in terms of, like if there's a unit comes out that's literally just the best of everything, then that'll sit above everything else. That won't even be on this list at all. It'll be, like, the one above all or something like that, which we don't necessarily have, to where it's like we have a unit that's doing Jiren damage as well, too, and that also transforms with the support and stuff like that. We don't have that in the game right now. So when we do have that, that'll change the game even more and be like, okay, that's that unit. That's the best unit in the game at that point, like that. Like, Beast Gohan is the best all around, but he's not the best of everything. You see what I'm saying? I hope this is 100% cooking. And I hope that you guys actually play along with this. Like I said, I will tweet this out, and you can do whatever renditions you want in it or something like that. Fix it up however you want. Even if you do it with friends, whatever, like, even other content creators, whatever it is. Like, if it's in there and you've ranked them yourselves, I'm going to look at it. Whether it's a live, if it's a lot, like I said, at the beginning of the video, if it's a lot, I'll look at it live, obvious. But if it's maybe like 15, 20, whatever it is, then I'll probably look at it. Actually, I won't say that. I don't know if 20 people? That'd actually be a pretty good solid amount of people doing it, to be fair. If it's more than that, that'd be insane. But like I said, I highly suggest you do it, because I'd like to see your knowledge on the cards, stuff like that, how you rank certain units, how your brain really works on Dokkan Battle. Because like I said, see where I'm going on this, or you see where mine is, but let me know how yours is. That way we can sort of stop a lot of debating on things. Well, you can still debate certain things, but you'll be debating in the said categories that you need to be debating in, and not like bringing other aspects in or something like that when it comes to the defense side. So when you're like, oh, this person is the best defender, then you're like, defender, shut the hell up. I didn't say anything about attack. I didn't say anything about any kind of other additionals. I didn't say anything else about crits. I just meant how good the tankiness is on this unit. It's the best. And then that's where your arguments go at that point. Other than that, then you're just arguing for no reason. At that point, you're just arguing for no reason. So I'm just saying, let me know if I'm cooking. Let me know. Other than that, have an awesome day / night. Stay safe, and I'm out. Peace.